So who's never been to a Kirtan before? Wow, this is Boulder, not so many people, but thank you. That's good. And we know what to do, right? That's pretty loud. So before we start, I'd love to start by introducing performers, but there are way, way too many of you to introduce, so we're not going to be able to do that right yet. Maybe we'll have a chance. So those of you who have not been to a Kiran, it's pretty simple. All we're going to do is chant till the morning, till it's time to feed the goats, and there are goats out there to feed, so you'll all be volunteering for that. And it's pretty simple. I'll maybe say some more things later, but for now, it's just pretty simple. I sing a line, you sing it back. I sing a line, you sing it back. I sing a line, you sing it back. I sing a variation, maybe you catch it and sing it back, maybe you don't. If I persist in the variation, you're like, okay. And you sing it wrong, and I hear you sing it wrong, so I make that the next call. That's what happens here. So we just keep going, we just keep going. And it's a form of meditation, and most, I guess you probably all know that it's considered the highest form for our age we live in. This is from India, this technology. We're not trying to be Indian, but this is from India, and for the Indian calendar, the age we live in, this is considered to be the highest form of yoga. Higher than the kinds where you hold all the beautiful postures, which you hold the asanas. This is the highest form of yoga. So I invite you to slouch back. Slouch back in your chair or on the ground. There you go. What's your name?
Micah.
Okay, Micah, he's got the right idea. He's got the right idea. And go do yoga. So I actually remember because Eyal is right here. I haven't introduced him yet. You all know him anyway, so we need to introduce him. We met a long time ago, but we were at the Omega Chant Festival. And one of the characteristics of Kirtan, see I'm a rabbi, here I go. One of the characteristics of Kirtan, at least in the tradition it comes from, is that you sing names of God. Different names of God. And I remember we were at this whole weekend together, Danya and Eyal and I. In Omega, and at the end of it, Danya comes up to me and says, what are we going to do about the names? What are the names we're going to sing? I don't know if you had this thing on her. She said, what are the names we're going to sing? And I thought about it, she thought about it, I heard the music, they made sense, and it was clear they thought about it, temple, and then I thought about it, and so it's a little tricky, we have lots of names, but what's the best name of God? Anybody? Under chant sheets. Page one, the second one down. It's a four-letter word in Hebrew. In English too. Ahava, love. So that's the name of God. That's the name of God. We say Ahava. Ahava Rabbah, great love. Ahavtanu, you have loved us. Who passed away just very recently, Shamdas, who is Jewish on his parents' side, or was, as he said, Jewish on his parents' side. He came up to me once and said, hey, Kirtan Rabbi, what's the Maha Mantra in Judaism? What's the great mantra? Without blinking an eye, and we would have all done the same, I said, the Shema. So real simple, okay? No singers here. one time all together. Shema. Story I wanted to say the other day during Chakrit here. I have been here a couple times besides being a clown. Mark, Rabbi Mark, what is
that?
Oh yeah, it was good. So I have been here a couple times besides being a clown, and I was here and I was going to talk to the group, and I wanted to tell you a story that a friend of mine, who I stay with a lot in Boulder, he's a psychologist. He's now a world famous psychologist because he wrote a paper that did that. He called me up during the campaign last year, during the primaries. It was still the primaries, I think. And he leaves me a message. He goes, "Dude," he said that.
"I do."
"Rabbi Dude." He said, "Dude, you're not going to believe it. The Romney campaign is using subliminal advertising." I don't want to get political here, okay? But the Romney campaign is using subliminal advertising, and I and a handful of others are the only people in the world who knows what he's doing. And once it turned out, what had done is that this other guy, Joel, who's a friend of his, another psychologist in New York I know also, they did a study in the 80s to try to find out, like in focus groups, to try to find out what is the phrase that makes people feel most happy. What phrase, to nail down, what is the one set of words that makes the most, I don't know, what is it called, serotonin or whatever? No, the other, yeah, that makes, you know, they measured it. Like, what makes you the most happy? And they did this study, it was a huge study, and they came up with it. And what they discovered was this one phrase. This one phrase made people the most happy. So he said, if you go to the Romney ad, this one ad on YouTube, by the way, this may all, I think it may have been a hoax, but it doesn't matter. This is Midrash, it doesn't matter. I mean, it was on these ads. The question is, did the Romney campaign really do this? It was on his, on their website, on their YouTube channel, I don't know. He said, if you go a 1 minute and 1 second into this ad, and you pause it, you will see it. And the thing about subliminal advertising is, if you say, drink Coke, and it's like written and you can read it and it stays there, you go, I'm not going to drink Coke. And if it's too quick, if it flashes too quick, you don't see it. So it has to flash exactly the right amount. Some of you are psychologists, I'm sure. Right, just the right amount that your unconscious mind sees it, but your conscious mind does not see it. So if you watched this ad, you would not see it. But if you paused, you would see it. So I go on and I look at the ad, and he's speaking in a field in Iowa with a big barn behind him, like beautiful American landscape, and he looks all healthy as he did. And I'm watching it, and then a minute and 1 second, I pause it, and indeed, on the side of the barn were photoshopped in, or whatever you do with movies, were photoshopped in the words, "Mommy and I are one."
Right, I love Romney.
Why didn't you vote for him if you saw that?
He knows who I voted for.
I don't know if you voted. So wait, so seriously, that flashed on the side of the barn, "Mommy and I are one." And that was the phrase that this study had done in the 80s and 90s to us, the phrase that makes you feel the most happy. "Mommy and I are one." Can we all go, mommy?
Mommy.
Go, mommy.
Mommy.
Go, mmm.
Mmm.
Go, mmm, yummy cookie.
Mmm, yummy cookie.
Go, mommy.
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 So that sound, the mmm. Shema, Shema, or Om, or Shalom, all these sounds, that sound, that the mommy sound, imma. That is the sound, I've just been taking voice lessons with this woman in L.A., that's the sound from which all your nouns and all your consonants and all your vowels come from. Ma, mo, mu, mommy, mommy, and I are one. But the thing is, here we are, we're doing kirtan, or we're praying, or whatever we're doing, and what we're really after, I mean, I want to stick with mommy and I are one. And I say this because my mother just passed away a couple months ago, so I'm really feeling it. But we're also here to go, God and I are one. God and I are one. Maybe mommy and God are the same. What do you think she'll do?
Yes.
You better say yes. Mommy and I are one. God and I are one. And that's kind of the business we're in here, is to make that connection. It's about making the connection. Horizontally between amongst ourselves and the mommy, God, and I are one. And then vertically, I've gone to shuls and said, if you just put out on that thing that says outside this week the sermon is, if you just have a little flashing thing going, God and I are one, God and I are one, you get a huge membership in that shul. Because you have this subliminal thing going, God and I are one, God and I are one, God and I are one. So we're going to sing in honor of my mommy and other people who've passed away. We're going to sing the Mourner's Kaddish as a chant that I wrote a while ago now. Well, I didn't actually write it. It wrote me. And it's about connecting. Back to the ones. It's about a lot of things, and I say a lot of things about it. But it's back about connecting back to the ones we've lost. It's on your chant sheet. On the first side, it's the next one, Kaddish. I have a lot more to say about this, but I have to restrain myself so we can get to singing. We're going to sing Le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata. Le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata. Beyond all blessing and song, even though we are going to make blessing and song, there is an app for that. I clearly don't know how to use it, but there's an app. So we're going to say La'ela min kol birchata v'shirata, beyond all blessing and song. Le'olam lo'ome almaya. Yitbarach shimcha, four times. Yitbarach shimeich, may your name be praised, feminine. Yeheshme Rabba Mivorach Leolam Ulo Meamaya. Yeheshma, may her great name be praised in this world and in the next. Leolam Ulo Meamaya. Now just give the teaching real fast that we heard from Reb Shlomo Kabach and Rav Shalom that we're not singing this. The people we lost are singing through us to tell us where they are. Can you hear the harmonium? Thank you.
May their names be blessed. May their
Kirtan don't like the zit splash. Kirtan want you up on your feet. So feel free to get out of those chairs. Or not. Yehesh me'rava me'vora Me'olam lo ne'amaya
Yehesh me'rava
Oh, no, no, no.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Don't nod off. So to jazz the mommy and I get one touching feeling. Right? So I want to give a couple props here that Ahava Rabawi did, my dear friend Shir Yaakov Feinstein fight, arranged. And he took it from a fellow named Shimshai. Anybody know Shimshai? Anybody love him?
Yeah.
And it's his song, Ke Aloha. So Shir transplanted it. This is the great world we live in. We're transplanting. Transplanting. Some of you may disagree with me, but I was just talking with Rabbi Marcelo Bronstein at B'nai Jeshurun in New York about this. He was asking what we think we're doing with this hybridization of India and Jewish and Jubus and Hindus and mindfulness and Jewish mindfulness, all of this stuff that's coming together. And you could look at it, there's one way of looking at it. I listen to MP3s of this very, very right-wing rabbi, right-wing in all ways. And he'll say, meditation, all the Jews are now meditating, you know, they stole that from us. You know, you hear his great gives great over great Torah, but every time he says the word Jew, I have to try to make sure I see dear human being. But he gives over great Torah, but he says, hey, they stole that meditation from us. That's one way you can look at it. And there has been call and response chant in the Jewish tradition forever. You guys have taught about that with Rev. Yeah, with Ruth. So there's been this forever. And yet, we need it somehow right now. I really believe that this is not an accident, that this is all happening. And I had a friend, his father was a great Christian theologian. Paul Van Buren is the father. He wrote a lot of good books. He worked a lot with David Hartman. But my friend Philip, who has a little edge on it, says some things that are inappropriate. He said, one time in the 80s, I remember him turning to me and saying, you Jews, like he was really into stereo equipment. He said, you Jews, you have like the treble and bass turned up all the way, both the treble and the bass turned up all the way. Never quite sure what he meant by that. But it took me 20 years later to realize, you know, we've got this chesed, we've got this love thing, we've got this strictness thing, and we've got the halacha, and we have the agadah, and we have the whole, we got these things. And what these tradition, what this meditation and this yoga and all these things that are coming from far away in this global world we now live in, what they're coming to do is to bring us to Tiferet, to balance this out within beauty. That's why we're doing it. And sure, we've had it all along anyway. That's true.
We just have it. We got it.
But we got it? No, we need to be reminded we have it.
We have to share it.
We have to share it. We have to go out there and show that this is a God of love and credit. Mark was speaking about this at 100 shut up this morning. Was that yesterday? Yes. About this. About that this is a God. Our God is a God of love. Our God is a God of compassion. It's about showing the whole world that this is this God. This is it's, and it's your God too. It's everybody's God. So, none of this is an accident. How are y'all feeling endurance-wise?
They look like they can really go back there. They're ready.
They're ready, okay.
We need to give them something really good.
Because I have some decisions to make here. So here's what I, every time I do a kirtan, you didn't do it. Kol HaKavod Lach. Rivka didn't do it, but usually the singers say to me, so are we going to, because then they get this big chant sheet. And you might have thought the same thing. Are we going to do all of these chants?
Yeah. Certainly hope so.
Yeah.
No. Well, we could if you stay long enough. But given that it's like a two-hour thing, I always say, well, if it's a bad kirtan, we'll do all of them. And if it's a good one, we'll do that too. So this is a good one. We're going to do, so let's do, I want to go on. I haven't done this for a very long time, and we did not rehearse this. So this is like going to be interesting, since he sharp guys.
C sharp, B flat, Om.
I think it's C sharp or B flat.
Oh, C sharp or B flat. Oh, anyway, they say this is the note of Om. Om. C sharp. So this is Hallel. This is resurrection of the dead. Resurrection of the dead. It's on the top of the second side. So, if I may have your undivided attention for one more minute. You guys will get it, don't worry. These are musicians, you can listen. You'll be fine. So we were talking earlier about names of God. And Danya came out and said to me, what are these names of God? Well, I thought about it a lot. And the most essential name of God may be Michayei HaMeitim, resurrecting the dead. I'll tell you something about that. I used to be a nursery school teacher, and I used to try to get all the kids to sit down. And I'd say, and I was just out of college, and I wanted them to like me, and they didn't listen to the thing I said. So I would say to them, okay, everybody, sit down. And nothing would happen. A couple days later, I tried, hey, everybody, let's sit down. Nothing. They didn't listen to me. Lunch me. A couple weeks later, I said, sitting down. And they all sat down. ING. Sitting down. God is a verb. Michayei HaMeitim, resurrecting the dead. This is God's essential activity, making this stuff that's this flesh, this matter, alive all the time. For that, we say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Any therapists out there?
If you're not a therapist, don't
reach out.
I'm a therapist.
So we say, Somech nofnim verofei chalim. I can't remember how to play this part, so we'll try. Somech nofnim verofei chalim. Umatir asurim. Lifting up the fallen. Verofei. And healing the ill. And freeing that which is bound. That's your job, therapists.
So make no
I'm 18.
Thank you for that. That's never done that way before. Usually this is a rocky thing, but you need it. Let's see if we can mechay on 18 ourselves for a little more energy. What do you say? I'm just a rabbi who walked backwards into doing music, so good to have people around within arm's reach. So we're going to do a little medley here. pretty much the last thing we're going to do. With the second side, it says zikr there. Ya is, was, shall be. Adonai melech, Adonai malach, Adonai imloch, le'elam va'ed. This is almost done, being recorded in New York. There's movements to this. Does anybody know them? You can go like this, you can go. Is it left first? I think you go Adonai melech, Adonai malach, Adonai imloch, le'elam va'ed. Now, if I had, someday maybe they'll make a microphone that moves and I could help you with that. But I have to stay right here. That doesn't mean I don't want you to do it. I can't go.
I think Madonna figured it out.
Oh, she did. So, yeah, I guess I can do this. So, this is Adonai Melech, Adonai Malach, Adonai Yimloch, Le'olam Va'ed. It's a little strange because it starts with the present. It goes present, past, future. Yah is, Yah was, Yah shall be, forever and ever, le'olam va'ed. So just to show that the present moment is the most important thing. I don't know, you can tell me. And then we're going to segue into my favorite sort of thing. Havayah. Okay, so what we've really been doing tonight, because, you know, they stole it from us. They all stole this from us. So what we've really been doing is something called ecstatic Kabbalah. That's what Kirtan is in the Jewish translation of it. It's ecstatic Kabbalah, which existed before the Kabbalah, you know, is a fellow named Abraham Abulafia. And they would just permutate names of God, especially the four-lettered name of God that we don't know how to pronounce, the Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. They would just permutate that into different things and put different vowels on it, and they would just get in these ecstatic states. And I tried that a little bit. And some people reacted pretty badly to it. So I called up Reb Zalman and said, Reb Zalman, what do you think about ecstatic Kabbalah? And he said, you better be careful with that. People go crazy. So I dialed it back a bit and ended up with this chant, Havayah. Havayah. And the words are Havayah, Eheyeh, Asher, Eheyeh. I will be what I will be. Or I am that I am, as Papa would say. I will be what I will be. Really means that God is saying, I do what I want. I don't stand by the rules of nature. And then the second part is Baruch Shem Kavod Malchuta Le'olam Va'ed. We say, blessed is the name, the divine name, the glory of her dominion is forever. Because Havayah is like as a sort of a feminine noun. So we're really praising the goddess here. So if you want to get, then you just ruin it. Take away all ability for interpretation. We're going to go deep into the male with the zikr, with the melech, the king. And then we're going to go into the goddess, the Havayah. So the most important thing here is to have fun. Have some fun. Prayer is fun. I used to only play harmonium. I started to play guitar. People screamed out, Judas! I guess that dates me. They screamed out Judas, anybody? Bob Dylan went electric. Thank you.
Thank you. Ready?
So now it's time to really introduce the band. I don't mean you. I mean, I do mean you. Rivka, a.k.a. Bert. Rivka Bacharach on, is that how you pronounce it? Bacharach? On moral support vocals. You guys are done. Guy on long on percussion drums. Aaron Wheeler on bass. And a man who needs no introduction, A.L. Rivlin on rock and soap and classic. And actually, I've been playing with a lot of good bands in L.A. and stuff, but this has been the best band. Maybe we need to work on the mix and stuff, but it's a good band. Really, wow. And then we have on sound Ace.
Yeah.
We did all the work. Thank you so much. That was a power tune for you. I have no voice left. I'm kind of done, but have not done yet. So I would be remiss in my capitalism to not tell you that there are CDs for sale over there. Thank you for coming, and for coming and supporting this. But if you think there should be people going around the world doing this kind of stuff, it helps a lot to buy the CDs and support. And you have CDs there too? Or?
Yeah.
Okay. So, and Ayala is in a temple is there with his wife Dani, who is Bisha Tova pregnant, where she would have been up here too. And thank you to Rabbi Mark Soloway for the inspiration. I've been looking at this room a long time, wanting to do a kirtan in here. And, it's a beautiful space. It's really, and you can feel all the people who prayed in here. I'm forgetting anything. I am teaching at the Olive Kala.
Oh, you should invite everybody.
Come to the Olive Kala. We're going to do, my course is called Kirtan as I Thou Encounter. As an I and Thou Encounter. So it's going to be boober. We can learn more about that. So, guys.
Yeah.
You're done. You're done. And I'm just going to sing Me and My Lonely Harmonium, just a little lullaby for all of us to go by. We need to turn down all the lights. And the words are on the bottom, but you're not going to sing either. Just lie down. Let's bring the energy. So we put a lot of yang out there. Let's pull it back in. That's good. So this, my friend, my dear friend, Debbie Friedman. Her dog and my dog were best friends. That's how I met her. My dog Goober and her dog Farfel. And we walked every day in the park together. For 10 months, and I didn't know she was Debbie Friedman. So she used to say, this one's for you, when she sang a song. Sometimes she'd say, I'm going to sing a song for you. So this one's for you. And the words are, the words are, Yehi Shalom Bechelech Shalva Be'armanotayich. Said to a second person, singular woman, to female.
So it's probably Yir Yerushalayim, the city of Jerusalem, that's feminine. But just imagine, touch into the second person feminine in Yir. It's a son to you. It's Yehi Shalom Bechelech. May there be peace in your walls. Shalva, serenity upon your ramparts.
Yeah, no.